few pop stars have the charisma, uniqueness, nerve and talent of the divine Sam Smith. Sam sold over 25 million records, picked up a swag of awards including an Oscar, and mastered the art of the breakup banger. How do you sleep when you lie to me? Sam spent most of this year at home in London, waiting out the pandemic and putting the finishing touches on a brand new album.
Welcome back to the show. Last time we caught up was in person in Feb. At this rate, we'll never catch up in person ever again. So much has happened. How's your year been?
I know, it's mad to think that we were with each other 2020 February, right? It's crazy. I'm really missing, actually, my friends in Australia. As soon as we can travel and as soon as it's okay, I'll be there.
I feel for you guys, though, because you said at the time you were terrified of it coming to the UK, and it's come to the UK in a massive way. Are you more or less terrified now?
I've had it okay. You know, I haven't lost anyone close to me. I think a lot of us are bracing for the winter over here, for sure. But I have faith. I have faith that we're all going to be all right. And we're going to look back on this in a few years as the weirdest blip of all time.
Oh, I hope. What or who are you missing most?
Oh my God, I miss dancing, babe. That's all. I'm all I miss is being in a club with like bodies on my face.
Then why have you created an album that's made for dancing?
I know. Don't worry. There's some sad songs on there too. There's some lockdown tunes. Don't worry.
Well, the film clip to Diamonds is very dramatic. How much did you love the rain scene?
Oh my gosh. It was incredible. Fake rain. I was drinking wine. I had my sister and all of my friends watching us. And we were just, I was freezing. I was absolutely freezing, but I felt like Beyonce. It was incredible. I was born to be in a rain machine. Honestly, I've been waiting my whole life.
To celebrate the release of the new album, Sam's got a special live performance planned at Abbey Road Studios, if they can get past security.
Abbey Road is such a sanctuary of music, and I went there when I was 15 for the first time to see it, and I really want people to see the musicality behind this record. You know, these are pop songs, but there's so much soul and heart in this music for me, and I can't wait to express that.
So why then, if it's such a sanctuary and such a special place, when you were 15, did you nick something from there?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, because I needed a part of the sanctuary in my house.
What did you take?
Do you know what? I'm going to be honest here. I didn't actually take it. My mum took it.
Oh, yeah, right.
No, seriously, my mum put it in a handbag. I didn't have a handbag. It was a mug, an Abbey Road mug.
But how fortuitous that she should take that, not knowing that all these years later you'd be back there performing.
No, I know. And she'll probably take another one this time.
Well, your album's called Love Goes. I'm guessing that COVID's played havoc with your love life.
Oh, my God, it's been a nightmare. I'm single during COVID. To all single people out there right now during COVID, I am with you, OK? This is a tough time. Being on the front line, can't go to clubs. Can't go out.
Watch out, 2021, you're going to come in hot.
Oh my God, 2021, we're going to go wild.
Hey, why did you delete everything on your Instagram from before April?
I think I went through a little bit of a moment at the beginning of lockdown where I felt I was oversharing a little bit. And my relationship with social media became a little bit complicated. I felt like I was living through it. The reason why I'm here is because of my music. So I just really wanted to reset the tone a little bit.
Sam might have toned down the Insta, but when it comes to style, they've racked it up to a 10.
I'm ready for someone to love me.
When we caught up at the beginning of the year, it was a big time, a big period in your life, because you had just come out as non-binary. You were telling me how everyone in your life was getting used to using they instead of he. 6 months on, how are you feeling now?
Oh, I feel great. Well, you know, my closest family and friends and team are incredible with my pronouns. It absolutely flows off the tongue for them, and it it's a lovely feeling. My mental health has improved so much from coming out as non-binary and talking about it. It's hard sometimes, you know. In terms of business, it can be difficult.
Why can it be difficult?
Some people don't understand, and people don't like to be wrong sometimes, and people are very set in their ways, as we know. But yeah, it's always going to be a struggle, but I can fight it and I can be strong when I'm feeling good here and I feel good here.
Hey, before I let you go, we heard that you guys over there, your health service, is using Dr. Carl from Neighbours to tell everybody to download your COVID Safe app, and we're concerned. You guys know he's not a real doctor, yeah?
of course, don't worry. Also, by the way, I've heard you're on TikTok.
Oh my God, I'm definitely on TikTok.
And you have gone viral.
Sam's seen my TikTok. My day is made.
That's stunning. That's amazing.
My new thing is going to be roller skating, I've decided.
Great. That's a great form of exercise.
Isn't it?
And it's very camp.
Yeah.
Very camp.
Well, it is always a pleasure to chat to you. We can't wait till you come back down under to Australia. We miss you lots. And yeah, congrats and good luck with the album.
Thank you. Miss you too.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, bye, bye.
And we're still waiting on Carrie's second TikTok.
Oh, mate, I can retire now. Sam's seen it. I mean, the first one took me 3 hours to do. I don't have that time.
It means you've got a 100% strike rate, though, so far.
Yeah.
Every single one has been noticed by
Sam. Retire now.